like many of you, I was involved in the conversations that took part in developing the strategy. And today we can already see that it's starting to have effect through the commitments you have made. Since this strategy was published in March, there are more than 100 positive initiatives towards the outcomes we all want to see, which I think is fantastic. HSE is committed to work with others in government to improve Britain's health and well-being, and we know that you're committed to that too. So helping to keep people healthy at work can increase productivity. That would otherwise drop through disruption when people are not there through illness. You need to recruit and that costs. You need to retrain and that costs. There's the loss of experience and skills. And as I said a moment ago, it should also help to reduce the restraint on the health services and the state that's got to pay out when people are not working, all caused by work-related illness. The commitments that we're here to celebrate span them all. We're certainly all acting together this evening, promoting the broad ownership of health and safety that's vital for turning individual businesses and good practice into widespread norms. Thank you for providing leadership and commitment to helping Great Britain working well. And in this historic venue, I think the following words of wisdom from Winston Churchill are apt when he said, "Healthy citizens are the greatest asset any country can have."